नमस्ते बिटिया, माई सेल्फ जेवियन नेहा सैनी फ्रॉम फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द एनाटॉमी ऑफ द टंग। द टंग प्रेजेंट्स सम मेन फंक्शंस लाइक पार्टिसिपेशन विद द नोज इन टेस्टिंग प्रोसेस, देन इट प्रोड्यूसेस द स्पीच, इट हेल्प्स इन स्वेलोइंग, चुइंग एंड ऑल्सो प्रिवेंट्स फॉरन सब्सटेंसेज फ्रॉम एंटरिंग इन टू द एयर वे, एंड इट ऑल्सो प्ले एज थर्ड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस आफ्टर द लिप्स एंड टीथ। So the tongue is a muscular structure that forms the part of the floor of the oral cavity and also the part of anterior wall of the oropharynx. Oropharynx is what? It is the part of the pharynx which is lying behind the mouth, behind the oral cavity. That is the oropharynx. So the tongue has the root of the tongue is attached to the mandible and the hyoid bone. In this diagram we can see the mandible as well as hyoid bone. So with the help of muscles, the tongue is attached to these two bones. Then there is superior surface of the tongue, which is the oral part. The superior surface of the tongue is divided into two parts, that is anterior part, oral, and posterior part, pharyngeal part. The oral part is the anterior two-third part of the tongue and it is oriented in the horizontal direction. And the pharyngeal part is the one-third part of the tongue, which is oriented more in the vertical plane. So the oral and the pharyngeal parts, they are separated with the help of V-shaped sulcus terminalis. At the apex of V, we have a small depression which is known as foramen cecum. Then on the oral surface, we have papillae. The superior surface of the oral part of the tongue is covered by hundreds of papillae. And these has taste buds. These papillae has taste buds for receiving the taste sensations. So taste buds on the tongue we can see on the lateral walls of the papillae. Now filiform papillae, the types of papillae, they act as an abrasive coating which gives the tongue a cleaning or rasping action. Then fungiform papillae, these are rounded shape and large than filiform and they are more concentrated on the margin of the tongue. They are involved in the sensation of taste and have taste buds embedded in their surfaces. They respond to sweet as well as sour taste. Then valate papillae, these are the largest blunt-ended cylindrical papillae, less sharp-end, and they are involved in the sensation of taste and have taste buds embedded in their surface, more sensitive to bitter taste. There is a set of 7 to 12 of these papillae. Then foliate papillae, these are linear folds on the sides of the tongue near the sulcus terminalis, as which I have demarcated. These are the foliate papillae and they are involved in the sensation of taste and have taste buds embedded in their surfaces. They are clustered into groups. There is no papillae on the pharyngeal part of the tongue. Then the muscles of tongue. The tongue is divided into left and right by median sagittal septum. This is the medial septum. So this is dividing the tongue into right and left part. The tongue muscles are paired and had two types of muscles, intrinsic and extrinsic muscles. Intrinsic muscles, they originate and insert within the substance of the tongue. These are superior longitudinal, inferior longitudinal, transverse and vertical muscles. They change the shape of the tongue. They lengthen, shorten the tongue for curling, uncurling of its apex and edges, for flattening and rounding its surface. They are working in pairs on one side at a time. So first we discuss about the intrinsic muscles. Of them, first is the superior longitudinal muscle. The origin is from the back of the tongue and from the median septum. Insertion is on the margin of the tongue. So in this diagram we can see the superior longitudinal muscle. This is the superior longitudinal muscle. Function, shortening of the tongue, curls the apex and sides of the tongue. Then inferior longitudinal, origin is from the root of the tongue, some from the hyoid bone, as we can see in the diagram. Inferior longitudinal muscle, insertion is at the apex of the tongue. So this is the apex of the tongue, and function is shortens the tongue, uncurls the apex and turns it downwards. Then transverse muscle, origin is from the median septum of the tongue. This is median septum. Insertion is on the lateral margins of the tongue. These are the lateral margins. Function is narrows and elongates the tongue. So this is the transverse muscle, which is highlighted with the green color. Then vertical muscles on the dorsum surface of the borders of the tongue, it is found highlighted with green color in this diagram. Insertion is on the ventral borders of the tongue. So it arises from the dorsal border, that is from this border, upper border, and inserts on the ventral border. Action is flattens and broadens the tongue. Then come to the extrinsic muscles of the tongue. They originate from the structures outside the tongue and insert into the tongue. These are genioglosses, hyoglosses, styloglosses, and palatoglosses. Functions are protruding, retracting the tongue, depressing and elevating the tongue. So genioglosses arises from superior genial tubercle. This is the superior genial tubercle on the inner surface of the body of mandible. An insertion, the fibers radiate widely to be inserted on the mucous membrane of the tongue, and lowest fibers pass down to the hyoid bone. So here we can see the genioglossus muscle inserting into the tongue as well as the hyoid bone. Action of this muscle is protrusion as well as depression. So here we can see the genioglossus muscle. This is the genioglossus muscle. Then hyoglossus arises from the greater condom and front of the body of the hyoid bone, inserted on the side of the tongue between the styloglossus and inferior longitudinal. Function is depresses the tongue. Then we have styloglossus arises from the styloid process. This is styloid process. Insertion is on the longitudinal part, is on the inferior longitudinal muscle, oblique part into hyoglossus. So here we can see the hyoglossus. This is the hyoglossus muscle where styloglossus muscle is inserting. Action, as the diagram is representing, it is elevating and retracting the tongue as well as pulling back the tongue posteriorly. Then we have palatoglossus muscle. It arises from the inferior surface of palatine aponeurosis. So this is palatine aponeurosis in the middle. From here it arises and inserts on the lateral margins of the tongue. This is shown in diagram. This is palatoglossus muscle inserting on the lateral margins of the tongue. Action is elevation and depression of the soft palate. Elevation of the tongue and depression of the soft palate. Now the vessels which are supplying the tongue are, it is supplied by dorsal lingual arteries, deep lingual artery, sublingual artery, and the important lingual artery, which is a branch of external carotid artery. Veins are deep lingual veins, dorsal lingual vein. These veins are draining into internal jugular vein on the neck. Innervation is very important. The motor nerve supply is by hypoglossal nerve, that is the 12th cranial nerve, except palatoglossus, which is supplied by the pharyngeal plexus. Sensory innervation is of two types: taste sensation. Taste sensation, these are the spatial sensations. From the anterior 2/3 part of the tongue, the taste sensations is by lingual nerve. Taste sensation is by caudal tympani nerve, and general sensation is by lingual nerve. General sensations means sensation of pain, temperature, and spatial sensations means sensations of taste. So taste from the anterior 2/3 part of the tongue received by caudal tympani, and general sensations from whole of the tongue is received by lingual nerve. And from the posterior 1/3 part, it is received by, the sensations are received by glossopharyngeal nerve, which is the 9th cranial nerve. And posterior most part, the sensations are received by the vagus nerve. Branches, internal laryngeal branch. Then come to the applied. First is glossitis, means inflammation of the tongue. There is change in the size, color on the surface of the tongue. This is glossitis. Then there is oral cancer, also known as mouth cancer. It is a type of head and neck cancer, and is very any cancerous growth in the oral cavity. Then the ankyloglossia, also known as tongue tie. It is a congenital deformity. In this, there is decrease in the mobility of the tip of the tongue because of the lingual frenulum. The lingual frenulum is this. So this lingual frenulum connects the apex of this tongue to the floor of the mouth. That is why the free movements of the tongue does not happen, and there is hampering of the free speech of the person. He cannot speak very clearly. So this is ankyloglossia. Then sleep apnea. In this, the tongue falls down and blocks the airway, as the image is showing. The tongue falls down and it is blocking the airways and causes stop breathing during sleeping. This is sleep apnea. You may have to strengthen these tongue muscles by some exercises. Then hairy tongue. In this, there is hypertrophy of the filiform papillae on the dorsum of the tongue, which appears like hairy structures. This is known as hairy tongue. Then candidiasis. It is the most common intraoral opportunistic fungal infection. Causative agent is Candida albicans, which is a fungus. Then pernicious anemia. It is the most common form of vitamin B12 deficiency, in which the tongue appears beefy red color. Erythematous areas develop on the tip of the tongue as well as on the margins, and also occurs in candidal infection. Then the case of iron deficiency, there is pallor of oral mucosa, deep papillations of the tongue, angular cheilitis, and there is other symptoms like fatigue, easy tiring, palpitations, lightheadedness, lack of energy in case of iron deficiency anemia. Then the questions related to this topic, which are important for your exams, it is the right short note on nerve supply of the tongue. So in this, you have to mention about the motor as well as sensory innervation. In the sensory innervation, you have to clarify the general sensation as well as spatial sensations. Then the second question is anatomical features of the tongue. So you have to mention about the tip, apex, the surfaces, borders, the papillae, taste buds, etc. Then for your file, you have to draw this diagram, colored diagram, as well as label all these unlabeled structures in your files. So this completes your topic, tongue. Thank you.